And welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika, and in this video we are going to make a flag animation. And you see there are two ways to do that. In one of them the left side moves, in the other one it doesn't move, so we are going to create the one where the left side moves. So let's start. To do that, what we need is the text and the flag artwork. I'm going to copy it from this file, so let's copy it and create a new file. It's a web file, and let's just create it. And the artboard is huge, so let's start and make that smaller already. And let's paste this artwork like so. There it is. And the first thing we need to do is take a look at it and make it into a symbol. So let's take a look at it, and you see the text object is aligned to the center, which makes it easier to later enter different text if you need the animation in a different context. So in order to be able to change that later at all, what we need is a symbol. And I'm going to make this into a symbol by using the shortcut, which is F8. Like so. And there we have the text flag. So this is all it needs. The next thing is we need a rectangle at the size of this flag. So let's create the rectangle tool and just drag the flag. The smart guides make it easier to adjust that. So let's give it a different color, and I'm going to make it green. And we only need the top and bottom line. So with the direct selection tool, I'm going to delete the sides, and let's do it like so, and move it into that artboard. And let's also now turn on the rulers to check the unit, which is okay. And the artboard, we're going to align to the pixel grid and make it smaller. Like so. And again, let's align that to the pixel grid, like so. Okay, so let's make a flag. And I'm going to Effect, Distort and Transform, Zigzag. Turn that to Smooth and make just one more ridge, like so. Okay. And then we can also adjust the size like so. And you see the bottom one, that is not okay. So we are going to the appearance panel and delete the zigzag. And then let's just take this. We don't need to edit the effect anymore. So let's just go to object and expand the appearance. And then let's grab this line by its anchor and press the Alt key and move it down like so. And now we don't need that straight line anymore. That's nice. Let's group this and on the artboard, center it like so. Now we need a couple more artboards. So let's just create them. And I need 14 artboards, so let's just make them. That's nice. And also they are spread out. Now let's select them all and rearrange them. I need just one column, and it's nicer and easier to handle like this. Okay, so I'm going to make this thicker so we can see it. And now what I'm going to do is duplicate this. Let's also go to View, rulers and change them to artboard rulers. So we can align stuff precisely on all the artboards, like so. Okay, and let's check it again in the transform panel. You see the center is at 100, which is a nice, easy round number. And now we're going to take this and move it down to this artboard. I don't need this copy. And let's go to transform again and check it. It's at 100 pixels. And again, we need another copy. And we need the other copy in the center. And it's, let's count them. So there are 5 up here. And then there are too many down there. So this needs to be 1 up here. Let's check its position. Like so. Again, check the position. 100. And in here, we need to mirror it. So let's go to the reflect tool, make a horizontal axis, and do it like so. Okay. And it's still in the center, which is nice. So the next thing is, let's select them all and ungroup them. And now we're going to connect them. So let's select them and join, which is Command J or Control J on Windows 2 times. Like so, and again. Okay, so let's now exchange stroke and fill, and now we need to check the stacking order. So let's go to the layers panel and let's see. So this is bottom, center, and top, and that's nice. Let's go up there and then let's create a blend. I'm going to object, blend, make. And there are too many of them, so let's double click the blend tool. And what we need is 5 in betweens. That's nice. And this is cool. So next thing is we can go to Object Blend Expand, like so. And then let's leave it and get to our text. And I'm going to move it slightly to the side. And we now need a couple of copies. So let's just make 1 copy and then using Command D or Control D on Windows, we are going to make all the copies, and it's moving them too fast. So, like so, and make some more. Okay. Now we have enough of the copies, and what we can now do is ungroup this, and then let's select 2 of those and go to Object, and then let's go to Envelope, Distort, Make with Top Object. It has a shortcut, which is Alt Command and C or Alt Control and C on Windows, like so. And let's use this shortcut to make the distortion. You always need to select the text and one of those green shapes and then make the distortion, like so. So next thing is those two artboards. We don't need them. And this is because this element and this one, they are the same. And we don't want them to repeat in the animation. So what we can now go to is Window Extensions, GIF Studio, import all the artboards. Let's use the button for that. And then we can select all of them and set the duration like so. And then let's test it. And you see this moves nicely. And now we could export it using the button and save it to the desktop, like so. So let's close that. Now you want to have a different campaign you are doing. So what you can do now is go to Window and Symbols. And there we have this symbol and double click it. And then you can change the text. Like so. And also change the color of the flag. Like so. Double click it to get out of here. You have a different animation and can export that as well. So that's how you can create this flag animation. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.